Hi friends, I am Sabu Joseph. Welcome to SVJ Academy. Today we are going to see how to calculate TDS and what are the new TDS rates for the financial year 2021-22. During the financial year 2020-21, that is the previous year, due to COVID-19 pandemic, the government has reduced the existing rates by 25% with effect from 14th May 2020 up to 31st March 2021. For the financial year starting from 1st April 2021 to 31st March 2022, what are the new TDS rates and its threshold limit? That we have to study. So every accountant has to know the TDS rates, its applicability, its sections, how to deduct TDS and how to account TDS, how to remit TDS and everything. So in order to avoid these confusions by the new accountants, especially the new accountants, I have developed an Excel utility which you can use very user friendly for calculating and deducting TDS. This Excel utility will be helped for deducting the TDS, for remitting the monthly TDS and for filing the quarterly returns. We can go to the utility. This is the report area of the utility. Here on the report area, you can see the financial year, all the four quarters, all the months and what are the sections we deducted TDS. So here I have deducted TDS under five sections that we can see here. And whether the deductions are subjected to Form 15G or 15H, the type of the deductee, whether the TDS amount have remitted to the government or not remitted to government, and what are the names of the deductees, and if you have branches, that also we can get reports individually. So these are the menus. Here I am using this utility for the financial year 2021 for the previous year and for the current financial year 2021-22 also. So we can use a single utility for every financial year. By the next coming years, we can use a single utility. In a single click, we can generate report for each financial year's data. No need to keep different files for different years. In a single click, we can get the data. For the financial year 2020-21, we can see all the four quarters. If we want the details of Q4, just click on Q4. You can see the data related to Q4, that is the January, February and March, a month wise split up of the data. Again, if you want to see the data of March, click on March. Now you can see the data of only March. Here all the data which is required for remitting the TDS and for filing the quarterly TDS I included. So we can easily remit the TDS and file the quarterly returns. And again, if you want by each section, just click on the section. Now 194A, these are the 194A parties, and out of the 194A, who are the company deductees and who are the non-company deductees? Just click on company, the company deductee details will be fetched. And for non-government details, click on non-government details. The data will be automatically fetched. And again, if the deductee have submitted Form 15G or 15H for the non-deduction of TDS, that also we can get here. Click on 15G. Here two deductees have given the 15H, 15G. So their amount can be seen, but TDS will be zero. And click on 15H. Three parties have given Form 15H. And for the other cases, which is tax deducted, click on not applicable. We can see the tax deducted deductee details. Remove the filter. We can see all the payments together. Again, if you want to see the deductee wise, click on the deductee name. That deductee details will be shown here. So when we click on deductee, all the data related to that party will be automatically fetched. Again, if you want to see the data by branch wise, click on branch, we can get branch wise data. So this is the report of the utility. Now we can see how can we utilize this utility for calculating the TDS and how can we enter the data to the utility. I am removing all filters. Now come to database. This is the database of the utility. Here we have to enter the data of each directory. So for the financial year 2020-21, I have inserted all the quarters data. Around 123 directories details will be available here. And here also we are starting from the new financial year 2021-22. So how can we enter the data? I will enter the data here. First, you have to select the quarter, whether it is Q1, Q2, Q3 or Q4. Here I am selecting Q1. Then select the financial year. Use the drop-down list. From here, select 2021-22. The next will be the bill date. Here, enter the bill date. I am entering the today's date. Here, the bill number, if any, we have to enter. Then the bill amount. Here, I am entering 25,000. In the next column, we have to enter the GST amount. In the bill amount, that amount will be included by GST. So, when we calculating TDS, we have to exclude the GST amount from the total bill. So, the bill amount is 25,000. Out of this 25,000, suppose 5,000 is the GST. So, enter 5,000 here. Now, the amount which is subjected to TDS deduction will be 20,000. That will be automatically shown here. On the next column, the type of directory, we have to select whether the directory is company or non-company. Here I am selecting company. On the next column, whether the PAN of the directory will be available or not. If the PAN is available, we have to select yes. And if the PAN is not available, we have to select no. If the PAN is not available, the TDS rate will be 20% irrespective of the concerned section TDS rates. So here I am selecting PAN available yes. The next column will be the nature of payments. Here click on the drop down list. All the available sections with its nature will be shown here. From the drop down list, you have to select the concerned section. Here I am selecting 194C, payment to contractor or subcontractor, HUF or individual. And under section 194C, I have given two options. One is for individuals and the another one is for non-individuals. So we have already selected the type of directory as company. So here I am selecting 194C, payment to contractors or subcontractors, others. When I select this nature of payments here, that consent section will be automatically loaded here, section 194C. And on the next column, it is showing the threshold limit for a single payment, 30,000, and for the annual payments, it is 75,000. On the next column, select whether the form 15H or 15G applicable or not. If it is not applicable, select NA, not applicable. And in any other cases, form 15G or 15H is given, select the consent form. Here I am selecting NA. When I select NA, not applicable, the TDS rate of 2% will automatically taken and 2% of 20,400 automatically calculated. Here, if we change the nature of directory to non-company and the 194C section applicable to individuals, then what will happen? The rate will be automatically come to 1% and here the TDS amount will be 200. Just select 194C, HUF or individuals. Now see, the rate will be automatically come to 1% and the TDS amount will be 200. On the next column, we have to enter the name of the directory. Here I am entering the name of the directory. Then enter. This is the net payable amount which is given to the deductee. The total bill was 25,000. The TDS amount will be 200. The rest of the amount will be 24,800. Here you can input the name of the branch. Here we have to enter the status of the TDS, whether it is remitted to government or not remitted to government. Here it is not remitted, so select not remitted. If it is remitted to government, here we can enter the name of the bank, BSR code and the date of remittance and challan details also. Now come to the report area. Just right click here and refresh it. You can see this is the new data we inserted in database. 200 rupees deducted. So this utility you can easily use, and don't worry about the TDS rates or its applicability. Any section we can use. Again, I will enter one more data. The amount will be 1 lakh. There is no GST. So the net amount will be 1 lakh. Here it is company PAN available. Here I am selecting section 194A, interest other than interest on securities. Select it. Automatically that section is shown here, and its threshold limit is also shown here. Here you have to select whether form 15G or H is applicable or not applicable. Here I am selecting not applicable. Now see, the TDS percentage is 10%, and the 10% of 1 lakh 10,000 is calculated here. And if we selected form 15G here, what will happen? If the deductee has given form 15G or 15H, there is no TDS deduction. So here we have to get 0. So just select form 15G. Now the TDS percentage is come to 0, and the TDS amount is also come to 0, and that transaction is highlighted by a red color in italics. So here we can enter the name. I enter the name of Mr. A, and you can enter the branch name, Mumbai. The status is not remitted. So you can easily calculate the TDS by using this utility without any error. Now come to the report area. Just refresh. See, the newly inserted item came here with the tag 15G. Mr. A, 194A, 15G, 0%. The branch is Mumbai. The bill amount is 1 lakh and the net amount is also 1 lakh. TDS amount is showing 0. There is no TDS deduction. So now we have to select the report of 2021-22. So click here 2021-22. Now this is the data related to 2021-22 starting from 1st April 2021. Here you can see when we selected 21-22, only one quarter has inserted data. So Q1 is shown here, and only 1 month data is available here, only the month of April. So during the month of April, we have deducted TDS under three sections, 194A, 194C and 194JB. So every financial year, in the new budget, the government will be introduced new sections, new threshold limits and new TDS rates. During the financial year 2020-21, the 194J has divided into two subsections, 194A and 194B. So here it is showing 194J. When we select 194JA, the rate will be 2% instead of 7.5% in the financial year 2021. So just select 194JB. Now the rate is coming to 1.5%, that is the 2% minus 25% of deduction allowed during the financial year 2020-21. So don't worry about the calculations. You can easily use this utility for the deduction. Here click on 194A. You can see the TDS which is deducted under section 194A. Click on 194C. Two deductions are under 194C. 194JB, we have one item. Remove the filter. Again, if we have 15G, click on 15G. One deductee has given 15G. Click on not applicable. All these are the deductees from whom the TDS has been deducted. And also the company deductees and non-company deductees. And also by the name of the deductee. Now we completed the utility. We have seen how to enter the data and how it will automatically generate the data. Now you may think about how this utility may help you for remitting the TDS to the government on every month. When we are remitting the amounts to the government, we have to remit the TDS by its sections and also by the company or non-company basis. Go to e-payment of taxes, tin.nsdl.com. Here you can see TDS or TCS, non-TDS or TCS. Click on the TDS or TCS. When we open the challenge number 281, the first question will be tax applicable, whether the deductee is company or non-company. Here we have given the company or non-company details. So take 194A section. Here we have only company deductee. So select the company deductee. The type of payment will be TDS or TCS payable by the taxpayer. Then select the section, nature of payment. Here we can see the nature of payment we selected is 194A. So here it will be 94A. Then select the name of the bank. Here you can enter the TAN number. Select the assessment year, your address, premises name, locality, district, state and everything. After completing all these details of organization, give the captcha, then proceed. So here we can use company directory or non-company directory and its section. Go to the 194C. This is non-company. So when we make the payments, here we have to select the non-company, the TDS or TCS payable by the taxpayer, then select the bank name, tax deduction, TAN number, and the concerned assessment year. For the financial year 2021-22, the assessment year will be 2022-23. Then you have to give the flat or door number, name of the premises, and all other addresses, state, PIN code, email ID, mobile number and everything. Then proceed. Now it will go to the bank portal for the payments. Here 194JB, this is also company. So I will show the previous year data, 2021-22. It have some more sections. Here select 194JB, select Q4, select the March. Here you can see the deductee type will be company. If it is for February, you can see the two deductee types, company deductees and non-company deductees. So in this type of cases, this is the 194JB and the deductee type will be company and non-company. So here we can easily find out the company deductee details and the amounts. Here we have to remit 223 rupees under company deductee head. So go to company deductee, select the TDS or TCS payable by the taxpayer. Here select the 94JB, here 94J, fee for professional or technical services. Then select the bank and all other details as usual. After remitting this company deductee TDS amount, click on non-company. Here easily you can get the amount. 1050 is the non-company TDS amount as per section 194JB. Here select the non-company directory. Then this select the section. So if we have hundreds of company or non-company data in a month, we can easily find out what are the component deductives and non-component deductives, and what will be the total TDS amount for that company or non-company deductive. So we can easily find out the company or non-company details and its concerned TDS amount by each section. Here you can see, when we click on each section, it will load here. We can easily make the payments. So this is the help of this utility for making the payments to the government. The next one is how this utility will help you for filing the TDS return. Here I will show you. Here I am using TDS Man software for TDS FUV preparation. Go to form 26Q, select the company, click on share and deductive details. Here we are entering the data of TDS remittance, challan details. I will take one challan which is already inserted here. This is the challan amount which is already paid for the last financial year. So we have inserted the challan details here. That will be available in the TDS remittance challan. After entering the challan details, we have to assign the deductive to the challan. So click on deductive details. Here is the use of our utility, because first we have to select the deductive name, then the consent section. On the next item, it is showing the date of payment. So in our utility, in the Q4 March, I have selected this is subject to 194A. Here I am selecting the 194A. These are the parties which is subject to TDS deduction under section 194A, and this is the total amount deducted. These deductives includes the company and non-company. This company and non-company details will be used for remitting the TDS. Now we remitted the TDS and going to enter the data to the TDS file validation utility. Here I am selecting the first name, the TDS deductive name, that will be a company deductive. Select the deductive name here, the TAN number taken. Select the consent section 194A, interest other than interest on securities. Payment date. This payment date is also available with our utility. The bill date, that is whether it is paid or payable. When we accounted the payments or the date of payments, that will be available here. We have accounted these details on 20th March. So from our utility, we will get the dates without goes to our accounting software. And here we have to enter the amount of payments. Here 36,532. Enter here 36,532. The rate of TDS for the financial year 2020-21 under section 194A, it was 7.5%, and the TDS on that will be 2740. Here in our utility, it is showing the same. Now you can save one deductive we used for the challan. So likewise, click on the other deductive details, select the name here, select the section, then the rate of remittance or accounted date. Here it was accounted on 27th March. So give it 27th March. The amount of payments. The amount of payment will be 12,71,998. 12,71,998. 95,400 will be the TDS amount. Our utility also showing 95,400. So in this way, we can use this utility for multiple purposes. One for calculating the TDS by its sections, its applicability, whether the 15G or 15H has given. And the second one is we can use this utility for remitting the monthly TDS amounts to the government. And on this third stage, we can use this utility for filing the quarterly TDS returns. This is very simple. If you want the utility, you can drop your comments on the comment box with your email ID. I will share the utility. So it will be very much useful, especially for the new accountants. They may be confused with the TDS deductions and TDS rates also. What is the threshold limit? Whether we have to deduct TDS or don't want to deduct TDS. Don't worry. You just enter the data, select the concerned section. The utility will show you whether TDS has to deduct and how much will be the TDS amount. So a single utility can be used for all the financial years. Here I am using this utility for the two financial year, 2020-21 and 21-22. If you really like the utility, please like, share to your friends and colleagues, the accountants, and also please subscribe my channel. Kindly enable the bell icon, you will get all the important notifications real time. So many useful videos are available in my channel. Most of the videos are practical session only. So you can watch that video. You can do all the accounting functions like a professional. Don't worry about the accounting work. So kindly watch my videos and like, share and subscribe my channel. We can meet on next video. Till then, bye.